We have come here together today, first to worship God and to celebrate the special union of Patricia and Bruce as they make public commitment that they belong to each other, and with affection and tenderness, they freely give themselves to one another. As a gathered people, we give thanks for the gift of marriage. We surround Bruce and Patricia with our prayers. We ask God's blessing upon them, so that they may be strengthened for their life together and nurtured in their love for God. A husband and wife are called to a new way of life, which is created and ordered and blessed by God. Marriage is a gift, a responsibility, a joy. Let us pray. Great Creator Spirit, you are the source of all love and the designer of all human relationships. We pause during this day of celebration to remember all of the blessings that we are inheritors of this day. We are grateful for those who have gone before, our relatives and friends, all who were part of our lives, giving of themselves and preparing the way. We thank you for the gift of their lives and that you hold them in the palm of your hand. We are grateful for the beauty of nature, for rest and relaxation, for relationships and love shared. And today especially, we are thankful for Patricia and Bruce, for their discovery of each other, for their willingness to commit to one another this day. As we surround them with our prayers, give them a sense of your presence. Deepen within them their love for one another, and strengthen them for the years ahead. We pray this in your most holy name. Amen.
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 Declaration of intent. Patricia?
Yes.
Do you take Bruce to be your husband, and do you pledge your faithfulness to him in all love and honor and service, in all faith and tenderness, to live with him and cherish him according to the ordinance of God in the holy bond of marriage? If you do, say, I do.
I do.
Bruce. Bruce, do you take Patricia to be your wife? And do you pledge your faithfulness to her in all love and honor and service, in all faith and tenderness, to live with her and cherish her according to the ordinance of God in the holy bond of marriage? If you do, say, I do.
I do.
Community blessings. Bruce and Patricia, you cannot do it alone.
Sure.
You come here as a couple on this very important day. Not alone, and not on your own power. These people here, and people who couldn't make it today, even people who has passed on before you, has been instrumental in making you who you are, and bringing you to this place. Families, friends, co-workers, I have a feeling that there are even people who seem to be your adversaries, who have helped you and shaped you to become who you are. It is true that much of how you continue to survive and thrive in your life together depends upon the love and support of other people, those here and those in extended community. You need the help and support, grace and guidance of others to make it through life as a family. And so, to the community gathered here today, I ask you this question. Do you give your blessings to Bruce and Patricia and promise to do everything in your power to uphold them in their marriage? If you do, say we do.
We do.
Amen.
Amen.
I'll read it. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boasting of arrogance or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hope all things, endures all things. Love never ends.
And now a reading from the Gospel of John. This comes from chapter 13 of John. Selected verses. Now before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and to go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water in a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with a towel that was tied around them. After he had washed their feet, he put on his robe and had returned to the table and said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you." Christine's scripture sure was nicer than mine, wasn't it? On a wedding day, right? Love is patient. Love is kind. Sure beats. Well, disciples, I'm going to get killed tomorrow, so let me wash your feet before that happens.
Yes.
Weddings should be all about romance, right?
Yes.
Weddings should be pleasant and happy, right?
Yes.
That's not always how life works.
No.
Weddings, marriages, relationships, even international relations all have their ups and downs. There are days when you really, really love and really like one another. And then there are those other days.
Amen.
Sure.
In a few minutes, we're going to celebrate the sacrament of the Lord's Supper, and we're going to break bread together with Jesus himself as our host.
Yes.
And it is Jesus who sets the example for us. Sit down at the table, break bread, make peace with one another. It is as true for married couples as it is for Christians, as it is for communities. When you break bread with one another, you can begin to live in peace. For many families, mealtime is almost a sacred time, once a day or once a week, that the whole family sits down and hopefully spends some quality time at the table. A trade foundation did a study about meals and fellowship. They did a series of tests and they found that serving garlic bread with spaghetti helps families get along better.
Wow.
In the experiment, those families who smelled and ate garlic bread not only cut down on the number of negative interactions between family members by nearly a quarter, but positive interactions between family members actually increased 7.4%.
Wow.
Most likely to be affected? Older males who had liked and had nostalgic feelings evoked by the aroma. Older males, Bruce.
Guilty.
So the study concludes, serving garlic bread at dinner enhanced the quality of family interactions. This has potential application in promoting and maintaining shared family experiences, stabilizing the family unit, and may also have utility as an adjunct to family therapy. So friends, when we celebrate the sacrament, we are doing that very thing, breaking bread together, affirming our unity, our oneness in Christ. In breaking bread, we break down barriers. In breaking bread, we increase positive interactions. We begin to live out the peaceful kingdom that God is working so hard to bring about in this world. And so, I think today's scriptures both give us a model for faithful living. Love is patient, love is kind.
Yes.
And Jesus says, "So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet.
Yes.
For I have set you an example that you also should do as I have done to you." Congratulations to both of you, and congratulations to you on your covenant life together. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Friends, if this were a meal for those who are perfect, Jesus would dine alone. If this were a meal for those who have never failed, we would not be invited. If this were a meal only for the worthy, we would go hungry. But instead, this is a table of mercy and of grace. We are invited as Jesus' honored guests, and we join people of all walks of life, from every race and nation, of every age and living condition. People will come from east and west, north and south, and sit at table in the kingdom of God. All are welcome at this table. Let us pray. We praise you, O God, for your abundant goodness. You have created the universe, all that is, and you continue your care today and tomorrow in unending faithfulness. We give you thanks for your unfailing covenant love, and that you keep covenant with us even when we fail and miss the mark. So as we worship together today, bind us together. Add your blessing to not only Patricia and Bruce, but upon all of us, so that we might know your love and instruction, and in faithfulness to you, we might live out your good intentions for all of creation. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Here is how we will do this. We have these one-in-all cups, and we will all participate together eating the bread, and eating it all together is a sign of our unity in Christ, and then we will all drink the cup together. So as the tray is passed, take one of these and hold on to it, and then you will receive instructions. Friend, these are the gifts of God for the people of God. All are welcome.
Amen. But I'm looking, the majority is. So far, no one is passed the buck. Oh, guess who I met today?
Who?
I met Elliot Wise.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, I've been around. This church is packed.
I know.
Thank you, Joe.
Thank you.
Okay.
Or something.
Okay.
And then at Baptist is, we call a carol, and we do the unity. Is that next door?
You'll do the vows. So after this, then you'll have the exchange of vows,
okay,
exchange of rings,
okay,
then the unity candle.
Okay, perfect.
Okay. You'll let us know, because we don't have the
program. We tell you what to do.
When do we kiss? But
you never get to. I'll tell you that.
He's already said it's not for the perfect.
Right.
Your sister could have brought somebody. I know she knows somebody.
She knows a lot of somebodies. So, can you get this dress, baby?
This is what
it's
I had to see.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
She hooked it up nice.
She did.
This is what I kept saying. I gotta go see the seamstress. I gotta go.
Who said it?
That's what I'm gonna say.
Oh, okay.
I have to go see the seamstress.
Look at them, they don't already drunk this.
No. Okay. No. Wait.
Don't waste it.
Oh.
All right, we got our organist.
I'm just trying to see who all in the audience, huh?
We'll see when we go to raise the cups. We'll see who did and who didn't.
I mean, I'm trying to see my former boss, Scott Poach.
Now, which one is Scott? Is that him in that suit right there? With the blue suit, red?
It is him.
Uh-huh. Ain't that him?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I see Steve Malone and Karen.
Mm-hmm.
Look into the audience so you can see who are all doing it.
Mm-hmm. In the same way, Jesus took the cup after supper, and after giving thanks to God for it, he said, "This cup is the new covenant, which is sealed in my blood. My blood which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, You proclaim our Lord's saving death.
Your boss, Daddy. Your boss. Your former boss.
Amen. And these are the vows. Patricia, repeat after me. I, Patricia.
Take you, Bruce.
To be my husband. And I promise with God's help. To be your faithful wife. To love. And to serve you.
As Christ commands.
As long as we both shall live. Bruce, repeat after me. I, Bruce. Take you, Patricia. To be my wife. And I promise with God's help. To be your faithful husband. To love and to serve you. As Christ commands. As long as we both shall live. The ring
is a circle with no beginning and no end. Mm-hmm. A symbol to remind us of God's unending love for us and our love for each other. Mm-hmm. One of the symbols for these rings is that in marriage, everything inside the circle is Bruce and Pat and God. Mm-hmm. And outside the circle is everything else. These rings are a reminder of the union of Patricia and Bruce, dwelling in the presence of God. Let us pray. By you blessing, O God, may these rings be Bruce and Patricia's symbols of unending love and faithfulness, reminding them of the covenant that they have made on this day. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Ready? Patricia, repeat after me. With this ring I give you.
Oh, wait a minute.
With this ring I give you
as a sign of our constant faith and abiding love in the name of the Father
and of the Son
and of the Holy Spirit. Bruce, repeat after me. This ring I give you. As a sign of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. God of love and grace, you are the giver and receiver of all life. We ask that you continue to look with favor upon this world that you have made and redeemed, and especially upon Bruce and Patricia. Strengthen them with patience, kindness, gentleness, and all other gifts of your Spirit, so they may fulfill the vows that they have made. Keep them faithful to each other and to you. Fill them with such love and joy that they may build a home of peace and welcome. Give them wisdom and patience in the difficult tasks of parenting. Grant your blessing upon them and their children, that their family might be blessed and be a blessing to others. Give Patricia and Bruce, personal courage so that when they hurt each other, they might recognize and confess
their faults, that they may have the grace to seek forgiveness and to forgive each other. Make their life together a sign of your love in this world, that unity may overcome estrangement, forgiveness would heal guilt, and joy can conquer despair. Grant that all who have witnessed these vows today may find their lives strengthened, and that all who are married may depart with their own promises renewed. Mm-hmm. God of all people in all places and times, that you for being with us today and blessing this union. When we go out from this place, enrich us with your grace and move us to serve one another. May we all be transformed, that your peace and justice will fill the earth. We pray through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Bruce and Patricia has chosen to use a unity candle as a symbol of their lives, joining as one.
Mr.
Before God and in the presence of these people, Patricia and Bruce have made their solemn vows to one another. They have confirmed their promises by the giving and receiving of rings. Therefore, I proclaim that they are now husband and wife. Blessed be the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forevermore. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate.
Amen.
You may kiss.
You're right.
I'm pleased to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Bruce and Patricia Dyer.
Congratulations, you two.
It was nice.
My sister Pat is, anybody who knows my sister Pat knows that she is a lovely, vivacious, kind, caring, wonderful person. She hasn't changed throughout the time that I've known her. The only fault that my sister has is that she chose Purdue University instead of my alma mater, Indiana University. I don't know how she did that, but I forgive you, Pat. We have eight siblings, eight children in our family, and my mom recently had a health issue, and so several of my brothers and sisters have to remain behind to take care of my mom. But my youngest sister is also here. The oldest and the youngest came to celebrate Pat's and Bruce's wedding today. Linda, would you stand up? And I want to say, Pat, I'm very, very happy for you and for Bruce. I'm honored to be here today to celebrate this union. I know you and Bruce have been dating for about 10 years now, haven't you? Somewhere in that neighborhood. And they've been dance partners throughout that time, and now they're going to be life partners. And my hope for you, my wish for you, is nothing but love, nothing but happiness, nothing but joy as you celebrate your lives together. And may today not just be the rest of your lives, but the best of your lives. So, I toast my brother-in-law, my new brother-in-law, and my sister tonight.
I'm number five, and he's the baby brother. He's the baby of the family. Me and him has always been close because my mother had six boys, and they were close in age together. And then she decided to wait a few years, then have Bruce and myself. So we was always close together because we were close in age. Getting in trouble together, had fun together. And my dad used to lay little coins around every now and then. He used to go steal a nickel or a quarter. We'd run to the store and buy some candy. We'd get back and we'd get whooped for it. So he always get me in trouble. He was always the informant of the family too, so he might get me. Didn't know who to go run to, we found out what happened. But we grew up, you know, I'm gonna speed this up. We grew up, graduated out of high school, graduated out of college. Bruce went on to become an accountant at this prestigious bank in the heart of downtown Chicago. I'm like, yeah, Bruce going to do his thing. Then he was working all of a sudden, you know, suit every day, suit and ties, suitcase, going downtown. Then all of a sudden, found out he just quit. I'm like, what the heck? What heck? Well, I don't curse, but I almost did that day. I'm like, what did he quit for? He said, he's gonna go do dancing. Dancing? What the hell? No, this gotta be some fad he's going through right now. This ain't gonna last. This ain't gonna work. But he had a vision, he was determined, and he had love for what he wanted to do. And how long has it been? 20, 30 years now?
22 years,
he's still going at it. So I appreciate the dedication, the determination, and the love he has to make the work And I just want to encourage you to apply that same love, that same determination, and that same zeal and zest into your marriage and into your wife to make that work also. Now, there's one more thing I want to say. Y'all might not want to hear this, but you married into the, now first of all, he always traveled a lot. So a lot of times we don't hear from him. He's like, hey, I'm in California. He'll send us a message, hey, I'm in Detroit, Georgia, wherever. So after a while, we didn't hear from Bruce anymore. And so my brother Nick called and said, hey, you hear from little brother Bruce? He said, no, I ain't heard from him in a while. You heard from him? No. And so we calling him, texting him, trying to find a way at. And you know, I'm not into Facebook or Tweezer or Twitter or whatever those things are. But my family is, my wife is, my kids are. So my wife came in one day and said, hey, I got this message from Bruce. I said, what would it say? He said he packed up and moved to Omaha, Nebraska. I'm like, what the heck? I almost did, Christine, but I didn't do it. Omaha, Nebraska. I'm like, what's going on out there? You don't have no family out there. So who is he? What's going on in Nebraska? Now I know. I know why he's up in Omaha, Nebraska now. So he never brought Patricia around at the start. He kept away from us for a while. But after a while, he brought her by, you know, came met his family, came to some of our functions, and we got to know her. And I just wanted to let her know that she is a beautiful person on the inside as well as the outside. And we love her. God bless you. Welcome to the family. And I'm going to say one last thing is that now, there's only one person that will be between you and your husband and your marriage, and that's Jesus Christ. Amen. Keep him in the center of your marriage, you'll be all right. Now, if y'all do let somebody get in between you all, well, you know, maybe y'all into that thing, I don't know. That ain't none of our business. That's y'all.
Briefcase. You know, that was to be admired. couple of years go by. We doing our thing. We in the bowling alleys. We doing this. We doing that. We traveling the world, having the best times. All of a sudden, like Alvin said, you know, you quit your job. But he don't know why. Here's why he quit his job. You see, 2 weeks prior to him quitting, we entered a dance contest. It was a Chicago's world's largest dance contest. He got cut.
Oh, I did.
First time. I got cut, but I got cut all the time, so it wasn't a big deal. But when he got cut, he cried tears. I'm talking this kind of tears. And that's why we use that word passionate for him. He was passionate about that dance. He lost. 2 weeks later, he's trying to start his own business. And I'm like, you did what? I'm watching you go downtown in your suit, you got your briefcase. Dude, there's a million people that would want that job. You walked off, followed your destiny. Your destiny was your passion. Your passion was dance. And therefore, the Steppers Alliance was born.
Yes, it was.
And see, now, you don't know this, but you probably do. You'll take credit. You take credit for anything. But you bring a lot of joy to a lot of people, you know, with your passion. You had employees. You had like 30 employees working for you, right?
Yes.
I told you Bruce was right. But you did your best. You had 30 people working for you, me one of them. Okay? That was all good. But now, I don't know, maybe you thought you was Moses or something, because now you got these people working for you for free, and they're paying you to work for you. And they pretty much, I know, they jumped on me because I didn't want to go with the program. So you kind of peeped over the corner, Steve, you're fired. Okay. A couple of weeks passed by, and he said, come on back to work. Back at it. And like I said, he brought a lot of people, a lot of joy, a lot of good times. We're having the best times in this place. He said, Steve, go over here and teach over here. And I said, okay. It was a good time. I got a girl here, a girl here, a girl there. It's a good time. And you look over again, Steve, you're fired. I was too tired. I've been on the same job for 30 years. I ain't never been fired. But I'm fired from a job that I'm not even getting paid for. So, but no, I'm gonna cut it short. But dude, job well done. You followed your passion. That's the word that I would use to describe you. Passionate.
Passionate, baby, to my wife.
And I'm proud of what you've done. And it's a good thing to call you my friend.
Right. Give him a hand, y'all. Yes.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
My name is Evelyn Scott, and I'm from Chicago. And Bruce, oh, Jesus. Bruce started stepping 22 years ago in Mount Liverpool. And I am so proud of you. I met Pat a few years ago when she came to Chicago. I looked at Pat, I talked to Pat, I said, next Pat, I said, Bruce, this is your wife. I claimed it. Because I knew she was a good one, and I knew she was what my friend needed. Thank you again for loving my friend, my brother. I wish you all a lifetime of happiness. If you have any trouble, you call me. Bruce knew I would handle him. Bruce, I'm proud of you. Take care of her. Love her. Be the man that she knows. Be the husband that I know you will be to my friend. Love her, honor her, respect her, and I wish you all the best. I love you guys. I'm sorry, but I don't like talking in front of people, but if I leave this out, he's gonna kill me. I told Pat and Bruce when I claimed this years ago, I said, y'all get married so I can be y'all flower girl. That was a joke. I'm sitting at my desk.
hello, I'm looking for a flower girl. I said, excuse me, sir, you have the wrong number. I said, oh no, I don't have the wrong number. You said you was gonna be our flower girl, you gonna be our flower. I said, I was just playing. So I honored him today and I came to be a flower girl.